Students, welcome back to part 6 from chapter 5. Today, we solve some more sums from exercise 3. See the first problem. The angles of a triangle are in the ratio 1 is to 2 is to 3. Find the angles. Once again, the angles of a triangle are in the ratio 1 is to 2 is to 3. We need to find the angles. Now see the solution. Given ratio between angles of a triangle 1 is to 2 is to 3. Sum of terms of the ratio. So what is sum of parts? 1 plus 2 plus 3, which is equal to 6. As we know that sum of the interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Then how can we find the angles from this data? This is your first part. So first part by total parts into 180 degrees. That means 1/6 of 180 degrees we get first angle. 2/6 of 180 degrees we get second angle. 3/6 of 180 degrees we get third angle. Now let us find. See the first angle. First part by total parts into 180 degrees. 1 by 6 into 180 degrees. 6 ones are 6. 6 threes are 18. So 630 is 180. So 130 is 30 degrees. This is your first angle. Second angle. Second part by total parts. 2/6 into 180 degrees. So simplify here again. 6 ones. 630 is 180. So 230 is 60 degrees. Now see third angle. Third part by total parts. So 3 by 6 into 180 degrees. Again, cancellation. 6 ones are 6, 630 is 180. 330s are 90 degrees. So this is the way we can find all the three angles of a triangle. So the angles of a triangle are 30 degrees, 60 degrees and 90 degrees. How to do the checking here? By adding 30 degrees, 60 degrees and 90 degrees, we get 180 degrees. This is very important, some children. Now, see the second problem. In the figure, DE is parallel to BC. Angle A is equal to 30 degrees. Angle B is equal to 50 degrees. Find the values of X, Y, Z. Now here ABC is a triangle. From this figure they given, DE is parallel to BC. Also they given, angle A is 30 degrees and angle B is 50 degrees. So this is given. Now from this figure, children, you observe this arrowhead lines. They given that these two lines are parallel. Now what about this AB and AC? Now lines means we can extend here. So by extending here, this AB line meet this DE and BC at two distinct points, at point D and point E. Now here it intersects at two distinct points, point E and point C. So we can call here AB and AC are transversals. When AB and AC are transversal, what can you say about these two angles? Just your concentration only here, children. At these two parallel lines and here transversals. Don't see here. Y is exterior and 50 is interior. So one exterior and one interior angles on the same side of transversal we called as corresponding angles. So as we know that corresponding angles made by the transversal are equal. Now here 50 and Y are equal since they are corresponding angles. Similarly here X is exterior and Z is interior for this transversal AC. Now again X degrees and Z degrees are corresponding angles made by the transversal are equal. I hope you understand here, children. Here DE and BC are parallel lines. AB and AC are transversals because these two lines intersects DE and BC at two distinct points. So these two are corresponding angles. Again, this is another pair of corresponding angles. Now from this we get here Y degrees is 50 degrees since corresponding angles are equal. After getting Y here, observe this triangle, children, ADE triangle. We use here angle sum property to find X here. Now here in triangle ADE, angle A plus angle ADE plus angle AED, which is equal to 180 degrees. Since angle sum property of a triangle. So by adding all these three angles, we equated here to 180 degrees. Now substitute the values. Angle A is 30 degrees. Angle ADE is Y degrees. Angle AED is X degrees, which is equal to 180 degrees. Just now we got it Y as 50 degrees. 30 degrees plus 50 degrees plus X degrees is equal to 180 degrees. 30 degrees plus 50 degrees, 80 degrees. 80 degrees plus X degrees is equal to 180 degrees. How did we get X degrees? Subtract this by transposing to the right side. 180 degrees minus 80 degrees, which is 100 degrees. So X is 100 degrees. After getting X here, as we know that X and Z are corresponding angles. So we will equate here. Z degrees is equal to X degrees. Since corresponding angles made by the transversal are equal, Z is also 100 degrees. So this is the way we can find three unknowns from the figure. Only your concentration you try to identify here. These arrowhead lines are parallel. These two are pair of corresponding angles and here another pair. Since they are equal, we got the values of X and Z degrees. Now let's move to the next sum. Children, observe from this figure. In the figure ABC triangle, angle ABD is equal to 3 times of angle DAB and they given angle BDC is 96 degrees. You need to find angle ABD. Angle ABD you need to find here. You have to find this angle. But we don't know any other angles. But here the relation they given here, angle ABD is equal to 3 times of angle DAB. Do we know angle DAB? We don't know. Let us take angle DAB as X degrees. So where is it in the from the figure? Angle DAB. Let us take it is as X degrees. So from this relation, what is the measure of angle ABD? 3 times of angle DAB. So 3 times of X. 3 times of X means 3X degrees. So we get here angle ABD is 3X degrees. Now you observe here. Now here these two angles form a linear pair. As we know that sum of these two angles is 180 degrees. But we don't know measure of the angle here inside, which is angle ADB. So from 180 if you subtract 96 degrees, we get here 84 degrees. So here you observe this triangle, children. So from this we can easily find what is the measure of angle ABD, which they asked. Now see here, in triangle ABD, first angle DAB, which is X degrees plus angle ABD, which is 3X degrees plus angle ADB, 84 degrees, the sum of these three angles is equal to 180 degrees, since angle sum property of a triangle. Now let us add. X degrees means this is 1x. So x plus 3x degrees, 4x degrees plus 84 degrees is equal to 180 degrees. Now let us transpose this 84 degrees to right side, minus 84 degrees. So 4x degrees is equal to 180 degrees minus 84 degrees, which is 96 degrees. So 4x degrees is equal to 96 degrees. So here 4 into x it is. So when you transpose, we divide this 96 degrees by 4. So do the cancellation here. 4 ones are 4, 24s are 96. So we got X value as 24 degrees. So what we need to find angle ABD. Nothing but here angle ABD. So here angle ABD is 3X degrees. So 3X degrees means 3 times of X. So 3 into X. 3 into X value is 24. 3 24s are 72 degrees. So this is the way we can find from the given data. Now come to the next problem. In triangle PQR, angle P is equal to 2 times of angle Q. and 2 times of angle R is equal to 3 times of angle Q. Then you have to calculate the angles. Children, you observe here. Angle P and angle R are in terms of angle Q. So first let us take angle Q as x degrees. Then how do we get angle P here? As it is 2 times of angle Q, we take 2 times of x, which is 2x degrees. Now the third, here the relation is 2 times of angle R is equal to 3 times of angle Q. So from this, if you make angle R as subject, this 2 if you transpose here, it becomes minus 2. So angle R equal to 3 by 2 times of angle Q. Already we thought angle Q as x degrees. So 3 by 2 into x means numerators we multiply. 3x degrees by 2. Now here, all the interior angles of triangle PQR we got in terms of x. Now we use here angle sum property of a triangle. In triangle PQR, angle P plus angle Q plus angle R is equal to 180 degrees. Now here angle P is 2x degrees, angle Q is x degrees, angle R is 3x by 2 degrees, which is equal to 180 degrees. Now here 2x degrees means nothing but by 1 here, here also by 1. If you find the LCM, so here 1 and 2 LCM is 2 here. So here how do we get here? In one table, 1 2 is 2, again 2 times of 2x is 4x. Again the same way here, 1 times 2 is 2, 2 times of x is 2x degrees. Again here 2 times of 1 is 2, that 1 is multiplied by 3x, again we get 3x, which is equal to 180 degrees. Like LCM only we have to find. 4x plus 2x, 6x. 6x plus 3x, 9x degrees. This is by 2. So when we transpose to the right side, it will multiply here. We multiply by 180. So 180 degrees into 2. Directly I send here. 9x degrees is equal to 180 degrees into 2. We need to find x here. This is here, 9 is multiplied by x. When you transpose to the right side, we divide by 9. Now do the cancellation here. 9 ones are 9. 9 20 is 180. Now what is 20 twos are here? 40 degrees. The value of x is 40 degrees. This x is nothing but the measure of angle Q. So angle Q measures 40 degrees. So once we get x, easily we can find the other angles. Angle P is 2x degrees. So 2x degrees means 2 into 40. 240 is 80 degrees. Now angle R in terms of x, 3x by 2 degrees. So 3x means 3 into x. So 3 into 40 by 2. By doing cancellation here, 2 ones are 2, 2 20 is 40. 3 20s are 60 degrees. So this is the way we can find the interior angles of triangle PQR when the relations are given like this. Okay children, I hope you understand. With this, I end today's class. Practice the same sums thoroughly and do as assignment. Thank you.